Oski recently took time out of his busy schedule to enjoy a tall cold one at the Marvell Nanolab. In this case, the tall cold one was a canister of liquid nitrogen. Before entering the 15,000 square foot clean room at the Center for Information Technology Research in the Interest of Society, or CITRIS, Bill Flanders, executive director of the Marvell Nanolab, helped Oski don a cap, a smock, and gloves to help keep his fur from getting all over the particle-free room. Oski is a big fan of science, and during his tour of the two levels of the Nanolab, he got a chance to interact with a few of the 500 graduate and postgraduate lab members who are building some of the world's smallest and most advanced technology. The lab is a hub of innovation for campus and beyond. The researchers design and fabricate a wide array of devices, ranging from nano and microelectric mechanical systems, NEMs and MEMS, to next-generation transistors. In fact, just last year, in May of 2011, Intel announced that their microprocessors will use a variation of the 3D FinFET transistor that was first developed at UC Berkeley in 1999. Much of the work in the Nanolab is built on silicon wafers, which look a lot like CDs or DVDs, but instead are the foundation for building integrated circuits. Oski found out that these wafers, held with a specialized tool that looks like ice tongs, can also double as a mirror. Under the hue of yellow lights, required when working with sensitive chemicals, Oski got a bear's view of technology's cutting edge. Over $25 million of specialized equipment, from high-temperature furnaces to plasma etchers to electron beam-based lithography tools for writing lines as small as 10 nanometers. In addition to the academic research, about 24 startup companies partner with the Nanolab to develop their ideas before moving out on their own. The processes developed and fine-tuned here are what moves companies forward, Bill Flanders told Oski, who nodded his head approvingly. And fittingly, on his way out of the lab, Oski also had the opportunity to meet some of the people that helped the lab evolve from a primitive but pioneering integrated circuits lab in the 1960s to an advanced nanofabrication facility of today. At the end of the tour, Flanders helped Oski, who clearly has an interest in high-tech innovation, out of his oversized clean suit, and the researchers quickly returned to their task of building better, faster, and smaller components that will enable tomorrow's nanotechnology.